All right, hello everybody. So today for our viewing, we have System of a Down's B.Y.O.B. and it's a lyrics video. Kind of would have liked to have shown the music video, but I'm almost certain that that would have been blocked. I don't know, seems likely. And I wanted to know what some of these lyrics were. I know kind of the main chorus. I do know this song. I kind of felt like doing a System of a Down song. I don't know what year this is from. I feel like this is a little bit of a later one, kind of later, or at least midstream for them. I guess that's it. I mean, I think we can just kind of get into it and see what. I think I'll probably have to stop at a handful of times to sort of sift through the lyrics and at least try to figure those out. I hope the volume is okay with things, so feel free to adjust your volume, obviously, but I'm still kind of messing around with that, trying to get the volume so it's balanced. I think on that last video, that Tool Parabola song, I feel like my voice was a little light compared to the music. I don't know. It's a never-ending journey. Here we go. B.Y.O.B. What does that stand for? Bring your own bomb? People use those acronyms in a lot of different ways. I don't know. Let's get into it and see. Let's go. Yeah. Okay, sorry. Great opening line. Reminds me of War Pigs a little bit. I feel like I think this song is a duet. I don't know if that's the right phrasing, but I think Serge, of course, sings, but I think the guitarist is singing a fair amount more in this song, too. Maybe it's more of him in this song. Let's see who... Wow, there's a lot to unpack already in the lyrics. Let's listen. This is basically a letter to the politicians who fabricate war, I guess. Sorry. What? Kneeling roses disappearing into Moses' dry mouth. Breaking into Fort Knox, stealing our intentions. Well, is that a reference as far as Fort Knox goes to the idea that Fort Knox is likely empty and not filled with gold? And the intention is what matters and not, you know, our intentions are worth a whole lot more than gold. Is that what it's referring to? Ah, is that the correct spelling for hangers? Because I pictured the other kind of like a coat hanger when I've heard that lyric before in the next part. But this is with an AR. Isn't that like a airplane hanger? Do I remember that homophone correctly? I think so. I don't know. Okay. Yeah.
Lies from the tablecloth. La 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 la. Everybody's going to the party, have a real good time. Dancing in the desert, blowing up the sunshine. Everybody's going to the party, have a real good time. Dancing in the desert, blowing up the sunshine. Blast off! It's party time! And we don't live in a fascist nation! Blast off! It's party time! And where the fuck are you?
I always thought it was, and we all live in a fascist nation. So that changes that whole meaning to me. We don't live in a fascist nation. Blast off, it's party time, and where are you? This has got to be a reference to like the whole bone spurs idea, right? Like all these presidents and politicians that never have had to really deal with any combat or military service in most cases. A lot of them kind of, maybe try a little bit of Coast Guard. No offense to the folks in Coast Guard, but or National Guard a little bit. But, and some, of course, politicians were right in the middle of Vietnam and all sorts of things. But by and large, most politicians making the decisions about war and all those decisions, international decisions, don't have the perspective they need.
Yeah! Where the fuck are you? Where the fuck are you? When our friends are fighting the war, why do they always send the poor? When our friends are fighting the war, why do they always send the poor? 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 Healing process is appearing.
So good. Yeah, I mean, William the Conqueror, I think he led by example. I'm not an expert on him. Alexander the Great. Now, of course, Alexander the Great made the the very politically correct or wise move to, bring historians with him on his conquest. That's why you can find direct quotes from Alexander the Great. Isn't that wild? From what is that about? 235 BCE, something like that. So he was writing his own history as he went. But if it was correct, he actually fought and was in all those battles across all of Asia. But yeah, basically, like if there's a big national emergency in America, the president, vice president usually separate. And they go to undisclosed locations with a huge amount of security because they're deemed too important to possibly lose to a violent act. Interesting that that didn't happen on January 6th in America when there were riots at the Capitol, at least that I know of. Anyway, I'm off track a little bit here, but this goes back a long time, is my point. This idea that the people making the decisions don't have to deal with the consequences of those decisions. It's not just about war. Maybe it's about getting heat to people in Texas right now or whatever. Generally, politicians are too disconnected from their constituents and the people of their country. The way it's set up in America is you might be a senator from Florida and you're deciding on things about the Alaskan pipeline for the people of Alaska. Sometimes that's good, right? But often people don't know enough to make those decisions correctly.
La, 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 la. Everybody's going to the party, have a real good time. desert, blowing up the sunshine. Everybody's gone to the party, have a real good time. Dancing in the desert, blowing up the sun. Where the fuck are you?
What a transition. Well, that's not a complicated question to answer. So the poor are disproportionately people of color and people, minorities. So that seems pretty transparent, right? My life experience is a little bit different. Some people, I'm sure, well, obviously most people don't know this about me, but I did serve in the military. I'm kind of in between a little bit on this, in the sense that my real life has been a dash of struggle, but I confess I've had plenty of white privilege opportunities too. So I spent 3 years in the active army. I stayed stateside. This is in the kind of mid-90s. I was really close to being sent to Bosnia. Part of my unit went to Bosnia, but not me. I was a mechanic in the army, but in an infantry unit. So I could have easily been deployed into a battlefield, but I wouldn't have been at the very front. I would have been slightly behind fixing trucks and stuff. I was a heavy wheel mechanic. 63 Sierra was my military occupational skill, MOS. But anyway, I can't pretend that I had this great struggle. I mean, I struggled with the military. It was a full challenge to be doing it as a teenager mostly. But overall, the people fighting the wars, and this is not just in America, this is everywhere. The people physically fighting in wars are the disadvantaged who don't have other options, economic or cultural, whatever you want to describe it. They don't have other options. So, you know, I'm not saying we should do this. I haven't thought this through, but I'm just having fun, not fun. I'm just having interest in a hypothetical here. Like, what if in America you said in the Senate, like if the Senate, if you have 100 senators, if you say the Senate votes to enact war for any reason, maybe most Americans view it as a just war, you know, I don't know, but for any reason, maybe a quarter of the senators randomly are also sent into that war. I don't know. My instinct tells me that you would have people voting very differently. I guess that's how we are. So that's part of the selfish being of human beings, right? We generally care about things that impact us personally, and we generally don't really care, or we kind of feign like we care about people that, you know, are around the world or dealing with some of these big issues. So there's a huge spectrum of how much people are involved and how much they actually care, of course, but generally, we care about our family, we care about our community a little bit less, we care about our, you know, our town, our state a little bit less, you know, like, and at some point, sitting here in Bloomington, Indiana, it's hard for me to relate to people in Borneo right now, or in Tasmania, or Sri Lanka. I'm just picking random spots here. It's hard to relate to people, you know, that you don't know, basically. So, anyway, I kind of got off on a tangent. I should stop. I like the music of that song. There's that little, kind of a hip-hop, kind of a light feel with that chorus part, but which is fine. makes it very digestible for the public. But I like the harder, heavier parts of that song. And the lyrics, too, of the harder part are much more compelling than to the soft, kind of dancey. Everybody's going to the, you're gonna have a real good time. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Catchy, fine, but not my favorite part of that song. All right, thanks for watching, everybody. As always, love the support. Really appreciate it. Notice it. I care. Peace, everyone.